Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonau.cloud, and I provide support with Apple Macs, Windows, Linux, and server builds. Today, I have for you again some news, and I will also in this video announce 3 lucky giveaway winners, so stay tuned. macOS Catalina. So many people ask me for help with Catalina every day. Fact is, I never recommended macOS Catalina to anybody. And reason is simple. It's still in early stage, by my opinion, not production ready yet. A lot of real Mac users have huge problems. If you will look into big production houses, they always run 2, 3, 4 versions older systems, because they need stable and predictable environment. So I still recommend to use macOS Mojave on your Hackintosh. For example, macOS Catalina 10.15.1 brought support for AMD 5700 series Navy cards. Nice, great! But it also broke support for example, RX 580 cards. And latest update killed HAVC support, and so on. Simply, Catalina is at this moment totally unpredictable for Hackintosh users. So I see no reason why to waste time and hardly try to make something working when it can completely break in last update. All my Hackintosh builds are running on macOS Mojave. Only on my 2011 MacBook Pro here, I tested Catalina just for fun, if it's even possible, and how it will run on such old hardware. For all of you who are still waiting for NVIDIA drivers for macOS Mojave or macOS Catalina, I have good news! You don't need to wait anymore. Yes, you hear right. Waiting is over. But not the way you want. NVIDIA officially dropped support for macOS with the next release of CUDA. In their official statement, in their CUDA toolkit documentation, they clearly stated, CUDA 10.2 Toolkit and NVIDIA Driver is the last release to support macOS for developing and running CUDA applications. Support for macOS will not be available starting with the next release of CUDA. I really see no reason why so heavily resist on NVIDIA cards when we all know, for example, even RX 580 can beat GTX 1080 in macOS. Thanks to tight integration in system and great built-in drivers against poor NVIDIA web drivers. People who are involved in 3D graphics, using for example Redshift Renderer or Octane, are always against AMD. Sure, but they should not be anymore, when Redshift and Octane announced they will release a version of their GPU renderer compatible with Metal and AMD cards. The only cards that are supported in the latest macOS systems. By the way, I believe even Apple showed their logos during their last keynote. A lot of people constantly ask me when I will build the new 2019 Mac Pro Killer Hackintosh. Nice. Do I look like a millionaire? Not so much. How many of you supported me in my work and builds? I will tell you exactly how many. 0.0115%. Of you sent me even single dollar as a thanks for my work. So before you will ask next time the same question, think about it first. I invested into help to you for the last year and a half $40,000 and I have nothing in return. In each of my video descriptions there is a donate link. On my website I have membership called Supporter, but quite nobody is using it. Everybody wants everything right now and for free. So I would need to first find some sponsors for it. Companies like AMD, Intel, Gigabyte and so on are not sponsoring me in any way. I didn't have a single sponsored piece of hardware from them. All builds I made for you, I paid from my own pocket. But back to the new Mac Pro Killer. First, it's necessary to have a reference point. That means to have the 2019 Mac Pro itself, of course. And do dozens of real-life tests and benchmarks. Then I can start thinking about any Mac Pro killer. So yes, sure I did it. As a more than 30 years Mac user, I bought the new 2019 Mac Pro. But unfortunately, Korea workers are in strike, so shipment is delayed. lot of detailed videos about it will come to my second YouTube channel called Morgonaut Media. So if you are interested in it, don't forget to subscribe also to my second YouTube channel. Link is in this video description. I will also show you how to save a lot of money on components for the 2019 Mac Pro, in case some of you will decide to buy it. Will the Apple Afterburner acceleration card work in Hackintosh? Wait for my tips. But don't forget, Mac Pro is a pure workstation, built from workstation-grade components. If you will build or buy an equivalent PC workstation from Dell, HP, Lenovo, you will pay even more than what Apple asks for the Mac Pro, and you will not get as many features as the Mac Pro offers. For example, dual 10 gig Ethernet or so wide Thunderbolt 3 support. So most of you ask me for new 2000 Mac Pro killer, but in fact you mean something much cheaper based on consumer grade components. So don't worry, I will cover all in my next videos. Also for who the new 2019 Mac Pro would be a better buy, and also for who to build a custom, much cheaper computer would be a better choice. Probably I will also do more AMD builds too, more virtualization videos. We will see. A lot of exciting stuff is coming to you in the next year, so stay tuned on both of my YouTube channels. And finally, now we have the giveaway. Two videos back, I made for you free giveaway of 3 free licenses for VideoProc for Mac and PC in a value of around $60. So, who are those 3 lucky winners? Magical moment? No, I will not make it long. So, first winner is triggere@something.com. Second winner is wipeoverhead@something.fr. And third one is anonychun@something.com. Congratulations! Already at this moment, you should have in your mailbox your license codes, so enjoy it. If you did not receive that email, check your spam or contact me. I can send you the license codes different way. And those who were not so lucky as these 3 winners, don't worry, I prolonged the offer of huge discounts on these licenses too. So in this video description, you can find, for example, up to 35% discount on lifetime license. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button below. Don't forget to join my website morgonaut.cloud, so you will have always access to all my videos, tutorials and posts. Morgonaut is always here to help. So, thank you for watching and see you next time, my Macintosh and Hackintosh friends.